Hello guys, my name is X1Gamer and welcome to another Savior of Uldum card review. I can't even count how many times I make this kind of introduction, but it's a review season. It's one of my favorite parts in the Hearthstone time when you see every day you see a bunch of new cards. Your mind is actually start thinking about synergies, about new decks, about comparing this card with the old cards, which one is better, which one is worse, how they can print this card, how cannot they print this card before, and stuff like that. So I'm very happy for you guys, because I want to thank to all of you that actually watch my videos in the last 2 weeks, because it's a very excited for me. I really like making this kind of videos. Even if I didn't have too many views, I'm really excited about making these videos, because it makes me find the synergy between cards myself. It makes me remember old cards. It's make me feel a bit more hyped about the entire expansion in general. So I don't want to take, as always, much of your time, so I want to go directly into the card review.
It starts.
Yes, thank you, Timon. It's definitely it starts. So let's start with the first one here. So this one was revealed yesterday. It's a formal 310 neutral minion, Conjured Mirage, if I pronounce this correctly. I hope to. Text says taunt. At the start of your turn, shuffle this minion into your deck. So this is a very interesting, very versatile and card that can see a lot of different kind of situation, a lot of different kind of possibility to play this card. So how I see personally, I see this card. So this is a 4 mana 3/10 when it stays on board on your turn. So this means that it stays on board for one turn, and for one turn when it's your turn, and the next turn when your opponent start playing his turn. For example, if you play against aggro deck, they need to somehow deal with this minion, but that's very hard because it have 10 minion and taunt, so they usually don't want to sacrifice all of their low cost minion, because if they didn't have a chance to kill the minion, this minion next round will return to your deck, and they will lost, for example, 3 minions and will not be able to kill this, and you will take this back to your deck. So they usually, what is the point of this card is that it's super stall mechanic, very similar to Doomsayer, but it's also in the same time it's different than Doomsayer, but it's somewhat close. So how I see this card, I see this card like you play this card on round 4. For example if you play mage against aggro deck, you typically play some kind of freezing effect or stuff like that to slow down the damage of your opponent. So this card do exactly the same thing, is just slow down your opponent. So your opponent will most probably almost never sacrifice his minion without have a plan to kill this minion, because he have lots of health. So it's very good one. If your opponent want to silence this, it's pretty much fine with you, because it will stay on board forever. 4 mana 3/10 is absolutely ridiculous stats for Hearthstone. This is probably the best started cards ever in Hearthstone for that kind of mana. 4 mana 3/10 is absolutely nuts. It's absolutely insane. So how other possibility have this card? It's a lot of possibility with this card. It's very versatile, because if you want to play Silence Priest, you can silence this, it will stay on board. If your opponent didn't kill this, next time you can play Divine Spirit, Inner Fire, silence. If your opponent have Taunt minion, of course, silence and kill your opponent straight away in the face if it's not warrior. Even if it's warrior, it have a high possibility chance to win the game just on that point. So this card is very, very good one. I give this card a 4-star card because I really like the design of this card. It's pretty, pretty interesting one. Super exciting card. Very good one, I think. It have multiple purposes and this is type of cards that I really want to see more often in Hearthstone and in any other card game. A card that make you think, a card that you will want to use your brain to strategize a little bit and think twice before playing this card, think twice before trading minion into this card and stuff like this. So is this card good? Yeah, it's very, very, very good card in general. Power level is good, the design is good, everything is super cool in this card. So I really like this card, definitely one of my top 10 cards. I will definitely make a video top 11 cards in Saviors of Uldum cards when all of the card dump is actually finished. So let's move to the next one because I spent a lot of time talking about this card, but this card is very, very, very interesting one, very versatile. So next one we have a pretty mediocre one, a new secret for mage, 3 mana as always, flame award secret. After a minion attacks your hero, deal 3 damage to all enemy minions. So this kind of a delayed board clear. It's absolutely very, very similar to explosive trap for hunter, but I think this is a little bit weak because it costs one more mana. So 3 damage is very, very good, but it's usually not enough to deal with the board, and usually it can be very easily play around this card. And even if you kill the board, if the meta is very, very aggro with small death rattle or a reborn minion, so you will have trouble clearing the board completely with this secret. So how good is this secret? Not very good, guys. Not very good. I don't think secret mage will be a thing this expansion. I was very, very excited for secret mage, but I don't think this will make the cut. So I give this card a 2-star card, very mediocre one. It's nothing too special. I don't even have to talk about too much about this card. It's just meh. We already see this kind of card. It's nothing too special. Maybe I'm wrong, maybe I'm not, but I don't think I'm wrong. So it's okay card, but it's nothing that you need to go crazy about. So let's see the next one. The next one, we have another insane neutral minion. 7 mana, 6/6. Battle cry, gain 2 of rush, taunt, divine shield, or wind fury, your choice. So this card is straight forward in the face. 5-star card, but not just 5-star, it's 5 blinking star, guys, because this card is absolutely nuts. This card is insane. Some people say it's even broken. I don't think the card is broken. I think the card is pretty, pretty good because it's super, super versatile card. It costs 7 mana and people typically play 7 mana minions in constructed. That's like the type of mana cost that you want to spend for a single minion in constructed games in Hearthstone. So how good is this card? Siamat. It's insanely good in my opinion. This is like the new type of the new Ziliax card. So the old Ziliax is one of the most famous and probably the most played card in Hearthstone now. So Ziliax see tons of play. This cost 2 more mana, but it's have 6/6 in stats, which is pretty decent. It is 6 attack. It's very, very good because you'll most probably kill almost everything on the board. It have a lot of possibility. You can choose rush. Most probably this will be the most chosen ability most of the time. You have wind fury, which means that you can kill at least two two minions. You have Divine Shield, which means that you can kill a large threat on board. You have Taunt if you're on low health, so you can use Taunt Divine Shield, which is not particularly strong because it can be silenced next turn, but it's possibility. So this card is absolutely insane, and please guys, don't go insane about this card, because this card will not work with Druid Quest. This is confirmed by Blizzard. This card, it's not choose one card, choose one type card. So choose one type is specifically only for Druid, so this card is exclusive and it has absolutely nothing to do with the quest of Druid, and nothing to do with untapped potential quest and this kind of stuff. If you have some crazy ideas to getting out of control with this card and the Druid quest, it will not work this way. So this card is obviously not, so I don't think I need to spend more time about talking about this card, because there is a lots of people that will actually talking about this card, because this card is absolutely ridiculously strong. Definitely a 5-star card. Great neutral legendary minion that is a must craft on day one. Because when Zilex was released last year from Boomsday Project, I craft the card on day one and I never regret this. So I will also craft this one, because I knew that Zilex will be absolutely insane card. And Zilex is absolutely not insane, but fantastic card that all it's played in all decks. This one will also be played in all decks except some hyper aggro mindless phase decks. So how this card can be a low than 4-star? It's impossible. It's just a great versatile minion, legendary minion. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have an interesting one for Rogue, 4 mana, 4/4, Saket Bandit Pirate, Death Rattle, return a random enemy minion to your opponent's hand. I think this is a little bit on the weak side, because the effect is way too slow. You need to trade this on the next round. Usually you want to play this, typically you want to play this when there is a big large minion on board. But how often you see a large threat on board in Constructed? Pretty often, because Cyclone Mage is very popular right now. So maybe this is a little small tool for dealing with the large threat, but it's a little way too slow for me. Playing this on round 4 does absolutely nothing. It's Pirate, if that makes sense, because this can have synergy with the Pirate legendary card, so you can drop this from your deck directly and will have rush, so you can clear the maybe even two minions with this. So is that good? Yeah, in that case is good, but if you play this on round 4, it's absolute garbage, because you'll do absolutely nothing when you play this, unless you have some kind of way to give this rush with Lucky's on round 5, or you can play this on round 5 with Lucky's and give it rush and stuff like that. So it's possible, it have possibilities, but it's still a very very slow card. So I think this card is a 2-star card. I didn't see that this card will see much play outside of this kind of pirate deck, but with the Captain Hook Tusk, I think was the name of the legendary card. The legendary card was when you play it, summon 3 random pirates from your deck directly to the board and give them a rush. So yeah, it have some possibilities, but I think needs a lot more support. If you somehow constantly will be able to give this card rush and trade it into the large minion, solo large minion board, I don't know, maybe why you should play this instead of playing for example Walk the Plank. I don't know, this card is a little bit on the weak side for me. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have another legendary neutral minion. 10 mana, 5/5. King Fairies, battle cry for each spell in your hand. Summon a random minion of the same cost. Wow, this is some absolutely insane effects. So what this means is that, for example, if you have 4 spells in your hand and these 4 spells cost, for example, 3, 5 and 7, you will summon 3, 5 and 7 minion random minion on the same cost, so you will summon 3 minions that cost 3, 5 or 7 and 7, so you will fill the board with minions. But how good is this? Not good. It's just not good, guys, because this is extremely slow card. If you didn't have any chance to actually cheat out this card, which is not particularly easy to cheat out minions and Battlecry effect at the same time, it's not super easy, maybe some kind of discount mechanic, but I don't see how this will happen. So how good is this card? It's extremely slow, it's not very good. Some people will compare this card to Nezod, because Nezod will have some kind of similar effect, but will summon a lot of minions, will fill the board and stuff like that. But you actually, with Nezod, Nezod is a way better, because Nezod, it's a card that it's constant, because you will summon a good Tetrattle minions and this card will summon a random minions. I don't see potential in this card, honestly, without any help, without any type of cheating. I think this card is a one star card, because it's pretty weak in my opinion, because nobody, let's be honest, nobody in Constructed actually play minions that cost more than 7 or 8 mana. So I think this is a pretty weak card, but maybe in some kind of ridiculous meme decks it will see play. I am that kind of person that like to play meme ridiculous decks, so I will definitely try this card if I got it from PAX. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have a very nice 3 mana 3/3 priest minion, Wretched Reclaimer. Battlecry, destroy a friendly minion, then return to life with full health. So this is basically a reincarnation for Shaman, but attached to a body for only 1 mana. Is that good? Yeah, pretty good. That's very good. I think this card is very good because of this meta. It's have full potential of Tetrattle minions, so you can play this, you can play Whelp, a mechanical Whelp, trade with Whelp or whatever, or hit the face in the Whelp, then destroy the Whelp. It will summon 7/7 and this will summon another 2/2 boy, which summons another 7/7, which is absolutely insane. Yeah, it's a slow combo, but it have really good potential. So this card is a very good card, 3-star card for me. It will definitely see some play in some ridiculous Tetrattle priest, because I think we'll see some kind of a Tetrattle aggressive priest with low cost minions that have Tetrattle / reborn mechanics. So yeah, this is also have a lot of synergy with reborn mechanic, so it's pretty good one, pretty nice started card. I think this will definitely see some play and will not be a card that will not see in Constructed whatsoever. So let's move to the next one. Next one, we have another neutral minion, 6 mana 3/4 Cartouche Defender, Taunt, Reborn, Tetrattle, restore 3 health to your hero. How good is this card? I'm not very excited about this card, because the stat is definitely terrible. 6 mana 3/4 is absolutely nothing, it's terrible. It's very dangerous to play this, and you need to, if you need to have trust, let's say trust to this card, you don't have to trust this card, because it's very susceptible to silence and other kind of hard removals effect, polymorph hacks and stuff like that. So how good is this card? Particularly not very good. Yeah, if it stays on board, it will heal you for 6, but why you will play this when you play on round 5? You can play Ziliax, which is a lot better, a lot better option than this one. I don't know guys. It just seems like too risky to play these kind of cards against aggro deck, because aggro deck typically run at least 1 or 2 silences in their deck. So if you play against Shaman Murloc, against aggressive Warlock, even Paladin sometimes play aggressive decks with silence, so this will be silenced and you'll be absolutely crushed and probably will lose the game, because spending 6 mana for basically nothing is absolutely terrible. So I cannot give more than 1 star to this card. I really trying to utilize, trying to think about more synergy with this card. Yes, it have lots of synergy with this card, but it's cost 6 mana, guys, and it's 3-4, it's susceptible to silence and polymorph hex effect. So I don't think so this card will see much of a play. Maybe it's a nice card in Arena. Yeah, it's a, maybe it's a nice card in Arena, but even in Arena it's a little bit on the weak side, because who in the right mind will play 6 mana 3-4 with when dies amongst another another minion that is 3-1, which is pretty weak. And the restoring 6 to your hero, it's something that you should never rely on, because this type of healing effect, it's never to be trusted. So this is the last one for today, guys. This card is literally revealed few minutes before I start the review. So I hope you enjoy this, and I hope you are excited as me. Thanks, guys, for watching. I see you next time.